The preserve whole object refactoring technique is about simplifying code by grouping data into one object. Its goal is to minimize the passing of arguments between methods and classes, which helps create an organized and easy to understand codebase. This approach is particularly useful when dealing with data attributes that should be handled together. Instead of transmitting each attribute, we bundle them into a single object for better code manageability. Hello guys, welcome again. Let's start by diving into the core concept of the preserve whole object refactoring technique. When we're coding, we often come across situations where a method needs inputs to get its job done. These inputs could stand for qualities or features of an object. The issue arises when we keep passing these inputs from one method to another, leading to a network of connections and making our code less adaptable and easy to manage. The preserve whole object technique helps us tackle this problem by grouping information into one object and using that object as an input instead of individual pieces of data. By following this technique, we maintain the integrity and consistency of the object. It also makes the code structure simpler and easier to understand. Okay. This technique falls under the method refactoring category in our refactoring diagram. Alright, let's talk about a situation involving a banking app. Imagine we have a method called transferFunds that moves money from one account to another. At first, this method needs the source account, destination account, and the amount to transfer as separate inputs. But as the app gets bigger, we end up passing these inputs to transfer funds in different parts of the program. To use the preserve whole object technique, we can create a transfer class that holds the source account, destination account, and the transfer amount. Now, by changing the transfer funds method to accept a transfer object, we gather the related data together and make the code easier to maintain. In one of our previous lectures, we talked about a technique called introduce parameter object. Both the preserve whole object and the introduce parameter object are ways to refactor code by putting related data into a single object. While they have similarities, they also have some differences. The preserve whole object technique is used when we need to pass multiple related data together as a whole. It's typically applied to a specific operation or class, where we put related data attributes into an object. On the other hand, the introduce parameter object technique involves creating new object, often called a parameter object, to combine a group of parameters that are frequently used together. This technique is useful when we find ourselves repeatedly passing several parameters to different methods. In a sense, the parameter object acts as a container for the related parameters. Okay, done. See you soon.